down and onset is a different discussion, totally different in the country with regard to us and its performance. Onset, I'm joined for that discussion by a very young Kenyans who are willing to open up their art industry in the country. I have onset Caroline Wanyaga. Thank you so much. She's the only lady on the set, gender balance for that matter. Good morning. Asante sana. Bari asubuhi. Karibu. I also have Brian Mwaniki. Good morning, Brian.
Good
morning. Thank you so much for coming. Darwin Wanjiru is next to him. He's an actor. Asante sana, Darwin. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
And of course, we have Laban Mashare, who is also an actor on Maifa. And asante sana. Thank you to you all. Well, all your faces are brimming with confidence. And I am proud that I have young Kenyans on set with regards to the importance of arts in the society. But let me start with you here, the team leader, Brian.
Yes.
A lot is happening in the field of art, and generally, Kenyans normally are so much concerned about what's happening. But I'll come to the nitty-gritty of the opening up of the need to open up the entire field of art in the country, why our actors are going beyond our borders to look for better pay outside the country. But do you see it as perhaps the precipitating factor, and how well do we need to see the importance of arts as a society?
For me, I can say, Sheng.
No problem.
Kenya iko ni, I don't think the government ina put much effort into entertainment industry.
Mm-hmm.
So utapata actors kama Kenya unalipwa
do
kiasi, unajua watu unexpect nimekuwa na kwateli. So unajua uko na domo, but in real sense unapata actor ametoka Kawangware. Unapata actor ametoka Kayole. Wasi wengine wameanzia Doni, hivyo hivyo. So unapata msee akika hivi chini angalie Kenya na cheki du huku hivi hakuna dona get. So msee ataenda wapi?
Anatoa hamie.
Ami huko kwingi. So tunahitaji gava put effort into arts. You see, tunaduka part time. Hiyo ndio kitu iko.
Okay. Darwin, yes. Talk to me about this. Besides passion, ni nini huwa ina kusisitiza ubaki katika the field of arts? I mean, there are many challenges that we know that normally artists do face in the country. We'll come to the play that you're going to be having tonight, this Friday and on Sunday.
Yes.
We'll come and talk about the importance in the society. But unaonaje kumekuwa na ufadhili wa kutosha kwa serikali kulingana na nyinyi?
Well, for me I can say, for the actors, we, yes, kuna fadhili, but the government isn't putting so much work and it's not considering actors in the budget and everything they do, you know. Like, everyone considers acting as a part-time job. And this is something that can actually change the world. Messages are passed across through acting.
Okay.
People change their perspectives towards something or anything through acting, through what they watch. And for me, I believe personally that acting can change this world and can make this world a better place.
Okay. Caroline Wanyaga, the important aspect here is that this need for the society and all spheres of the society to embrace the importance of arts in the society. I mean, because they normally communicate important messages, convey extra information on what happens in the society in a nutshell so that you can get an understanding, appreciate the happenings. But do you see a situation where all these challenges as a result of lack of support, especially from the government side, and of course the willing corporate organization, and how well are you surviving in that very tight environment?
The lack of support is a big issue. I will not say that, because most of the times you find we have to fund ourselves. We have to pay for our theater. We have to do everything. That includes even paying yourself. You have to market your own shows. So the lack of support is a big issue, but also if the government could put just a little bit more effort into art. You know, art states the critical issues in the society.
Okay.
It states the underlying issues that no one is willing to point out. If the government would put just a little bit more effort, I think it would really help the society. Because we talk about issues no one is comfortable pointing out in the society.
Okay.
If the government would put just a little bit more effort, I think it would be easier to reflect those issues, because art is like a mirror for the society. I just wish the government would put a little bit more effort.
Okay, Laban Masharia, talk to me about your perspective in terms of the differences of your thoughts. And how crucial is the support in this case with regard to our artists? Because the reports that we normally get is that they go beyond our borders to seek better pay, and their talent is appreciated elsewhere instead of Kenya here, where they were born, bred, and brought up. So how well do we need to put our house in order and keep our artists in regard to that, build up a society that appreciates the importance of art and keep our artists within our coffers?
Okay, for me, sister kuingelea gava sana, but I would say that I guess it all starts with the writing, maybe, you know, the writing of the play. Like for me, I'm a writer, so it all starts with the quality, you see. I think it has come a point that Kenyans require the quality, you know. They see like any place that Kenya ma something that is done in Kenya, iko chini kidogo. So, but you see, if we meet the standard, maybe like Hollywood, amaizo vitu vingine, I think they will appreciate more. And I think for now, we can see that kama YouTube ukiingia, vitu za Kenya, they are trending, you see. Nikumaanisha Kenyans have started appreciating. So, let us not rely sana hivyo na gava, you know. Let us be like self-reliance. Like kama sahi hapa hivi Giza Arts, hakuna mahali yeti gava imeingilia, naona. We are like self, naona, we are like self-made. So if we continue pushing that way, you see, the Kenyan audience will warm up to us, you see. And as we continue, maybe shows takuwa zikiwa na jaa, something like that, takuwa naendelea zikiwa na happen. So let us not open lands on the government issue.
Okay, Brian. Nieleze kuhusu hii mambo sasa. Not necessarily per se that you need a government support. Sio lazima kuwe na nini ya support gava. Sasa nyinyi mnajikakamuaje?
Kujikakamua ni kujimarket, unajua. Mimi kama nikipatiwa tickets, nitaenda niuzie my best zangu, classmates, you know.
Put Facebook kila mahali.
Kila mahali, my family, friends, wakam, kila mtu wakam show. The same with them. That's how we promote ourselves. Sasa Kenya tunaweza sema ni for hii industry prosper. We need it to be like a profession, unajua? Isikuwe downgraded, ikuwe na equity in every profession, unajua? Wasitone watu wa art ka outcast, unajua? Wakituweka profession kama kila kitu ingine. Maybe, unajua, maybe. Tutakuwa standard za Hollywood. Jua kianza kupampi ndo, promotions ikamu. Kila mtu anza kusupport art. Si gava peke yake. Kila mtu, ikamu through. Tutafika faa. But sasa, si as Kenyans, at promoting vitu ze.
Jetu.
Iyo ndo yuko angashi detu sana.
Huwa tunapromote vitu vingine.
Unapata kila mtoko, Avengers imetokea, nani atacheki movie ya Kenya Nairobi Half-Life? Hakuna msa atacheki. Kila mtu ataka kucheki. So budget hii, kuwena budget ya entertainment, unajua. Ikieko hivo, tutafika hizo standards.
Okay, Darwin. Yes. Then what comes into the picture here, into the framing of the debate and the discussion here, the epicenter of all this is perhaps the quality of the production.
Okay.
Yes, you are self-reliant, you are bankrolling yourself, but at the end of the day, what matters is the quality of your production.
Yeah.
How well does it resonate? What message are you communicating? Because that in itself, without a support even, can sell you. Yes, there can be financial problems, but it can sell you. So how are you dwelling on that bit of quality before the support comes in?
Okay, what majorly we focus on is, you know, we use the statement, art is meant to comfort the disturbed and disturb the comfortable. So when people actually see your production, they should be able to get something from it, you know. They go home having learned something, being inspired and motivated to do something differently than what they were doing, you know, to maybe... Like for the play we are doing now, it talks about support of actors. And you majorly see that there's no support totally from every corner.
Okay.
From your family, there's no support. From your friends, there's no support. Even the people you work with themselves already downgrading you, whether you're a new actor. People are just saying, this is a new actor, man. We can't work with you. You know, like there's no aspect of support from every single corner. Yeah. So I think we should embrace each other, and you know, we weren't born actors, all of us. We weren't born doctors. We learned from someone and we got to be the best we can be. So I think we should embrace each and everyone and just try to move forward with each other, you know. And for the case of quality, we try as much as we can to make sure we have good quality productions, because at the end of it all, people want to come and have fun.
Okay.
And that's why we try as much as possible. As we pass the message, we make sure people have had fun.
Okay.
And it's all a compact thing at the end of the day.
A package.
You know? Yeah, it's a package. Yeah.
Okay, Caroline, I want to know your role kindly. The name of the play set for today and Sunday its importance in the society, and what you intend to convey.
Okay. The play is titled Avirisha Zavirina.
Mm-hmm.
I am playing the role of a mother, Sarai. Mm.
Okay.
I am this mother who is into conventional careers. Mm-hmm. I totally don't support my son.
Okay.
I would prefer if my son did a conventional career because I'd think it would make more money for him, but I don't think that's how it should be.
Okay.
The play is generally about the plight of artists.
Okay.
In the play, you can see two groups, mm-hmm. two acting groups,
okay.
Lazarina and Karae.
Mm-hmm.
In one group, on one side of the group of the play, there's a group that's totally oppressed.
Okay.
The CEO is embezzling money,
mm-hmm.
and you can see the difference
because
when the CEO takes the money, the artists suffer, they can't pay their rent, they can't mm-hmm. foot their bills.
Okay.
But on the other side, there's Mikarai. The CEO is good to the artists,
okay.
so the empire rises and the artists in the end grow.
Okay.
You can even see the difference during because of the support.
In terms of the career success.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
In the end, one of the groups fails completely because of lack of support from even their management, while the other rises.
Okay.
So people should probably try to support.
So that's what's forthcoming tonight.
Yes.
And it showcases the plight of the artist.